Let's talk a bit more in detail about the dearMoon mission. You know, the mission where Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa wants to do a round trip around the moon in 2023 with Starship.
Could it actually really be done by 2023, or is this just another case of Elon time? And how will the mission look exactly? Well, I would say let's try to find out. So, the dearMoon mission. We have mentioned it already plenty of times, but we haven't yet presented all the details that are currently known about this fascinating lunar round-trip mission. So, let's try to correct that. Some of you might remember that in early 2017, on the 27th of February to be precise, SpaceX announced that they were planning to send two space tourists on a round trip around the moon. The mission would have launched in late 2018, but of course it wouldn't have employed the Starship, since even today Starship isn't yet ready to fly to space, but it would have employed a Crew Dragon capsule in combination with a Falcon Heavy rocket. It is now known that one of the two space tourists who would have flown on Crew Dragon around the moon was Yusaku Maezawa. Man, this guy really wants to fly around the moon. Another unknown person would have joined him on this trip. It would have been a roughly 6-day trip on a free return trajectory. This means that the spacecraft would not have inserted itself into a stable moon orbit, but it would have used the gravity of the moon to slingshot itself around the moon back to Earth. We will talk more about free return trajectories later.
Fascinatingly, back in February 2017, the Falcon Heavy had not even had its first maiden flight yet. This would happen 1 year later, on February 6, 2018. In that very month, SpaceX then announced that they had scrapped the plans to fly the two space tourists around the moon with Falcon Heavy and Crew Dragon, but would instead directly employ Starship, or rather the BFR, as it was still being called back then. So then on September 14, 2018, SpaceX made a big announcement, where this lunar round-trip mission then became known as the dearMoon mission. A few details were released on this mission, namely that the aforementioned Yusaku Maezawa would fly aboard Starship, and that he wanted 8 artists to join him on this mission. Then at least one, but more likely 2 or 3 SpaceX personnel would have joined, which of course makes sense, because you always need specialists on board who are very familiar with the ship. Some fancy animations were shown and a date was given, 2023, and there was also a lunar round-trip trajectory shown. It consisted of the following stages. 1. Launch. 2. Booster separation, where the BFR second stage, now known as Starship, would detach from the first stage, now known as Super Heavy. 3. The BFR would coast for a while in the parking orbit, before performing the famous translunar injection burn. 4. This is where the spacecraft would burn the 3 vacuum reactor engines to create acceleration in order to leave Earth orbit and fly towards the moon. Thus, it's called lunar insertion. Then Starship would fly the distance towards the moon in about 2.5 days. It would then be captured by the moon's gravity at 5, be slingshotted around the far side of the moon at 6, witness the Earth rise at 7, and then leave the lunar vicinity at 8. The BFR, or Starship, would then spend 2.5 days on Earth return trip again. Upon arrival at Earth, it would then begin the re-entry burn at 9, and then perform the landing. The last landing part, now we know that it works, since March 4th. This is really nice, because that's actually one of the hardest parts of the entire journey. But note, that something is missing here. Yes, yes, something is missing. Do you know it? Before we answer this question though, please subscribe to our channel, because we don't only talk about SpaceX or Starship related topics, but in fact we like to talk about all spaceflight related and other disruptive technologies. So thank you very much for your support in advance.
So the observant among you will have noticed that there are no refueling tanker starships involved in this whole lunar round-trip mission. Why is this? Well, we would only need to refuel Starship in Earth orbit if Starship would enter lunar orbit in a lunar orbit injection burn. It would then need to escape Moon orbit again by performing an equally strong burn to leave Moon orbit. But since the Starship is slingshotted around the Moon in a free return trajectory, no additional fuel is required. Starship just burns once in the beginning for entering translunar injection and then not again, until at the very end, of course, it would burn for a few seconds for the landing on Earth. There are actually four different types of lunar free return trajectories that can work, as you can see here. SpaceX will perform the first type, the coplanar circumlunar free return. Of course, for actually landing on the Moon, more refuelings with tanker starships will be needed. For landing 100 metric tons of cargo on the Moon with lunar Starship, you will actually need at least 5 refueling tankers to fuel up Starship in orbit, so that it has enough fuel to land all that mass on the Moon, and then still have enough propellant left to lift off from the lunar surface. Anyways, back to Dear Moon. So this was the plan as detailed in September 2018, and that was the status until Yusaku released an update on the whole Dear Moon project on March 2nd this year. So the only difference in this plan as compared to the one from back in 2018 is that of course now we are not talking about BFR anymore, but about Starship and Super Heavy. Accordingly, some new renderings were released too on the Dear Moon website, depicting the latest Starship design iteration as it would appear throughout the mission. Here during liftoff with the Super Heavy, here in low Earth orbit, and then here finally in lunar vicinity. In this rendering, we can especially nicely see the hexagonal heat shield tiles for re-entry.
And you might have noticed that we now suddenly have a Falcon 9 and a Falcon Heavy model standing in the background. Well, we got these really cool 3D printed models from Bohimso. They run an excellent 3D printing service on Etsy.com. And you can find the link to their Etsy shop in the video description below. But of course, they don't only make really high quality 3D models of Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy, but of a lot of other SpaceX hardware as well, such as Crew Dragon, Dragon XL, and of course Starship. This one here is the latest iteration of Starship, complete with the 6 decks, viewing gallery, SpaceX logo, and even the landing racks. Bohimso offers worldwide shipping, and as if that wasn't enough, they have a 5-star rating on Etsy at over 300 reviews. This is really quite an achievement. And if you have any questions about their 3D models or your order, don't hesitate to ask, because they will reply to you within 24 hours. We love the space models from Bohimso a lot, so you will certainly see more of them in our future videos.
So back to Yusaku. The Starship design has been updated, of course, but Yusaku also gave an update on who can join him. Basically, anyone now. The definition of what it means to be an artist is quite vague, so everyone who's doing a bit of artistic stuff can be considered an artist. So anyone can apply on the Dear Moon website. Wow, You've once drawn a picture as a child? Perfect, you're an artist, you can join. You've once sung a song during the drive to work? Perfect, you're an artist, you can join. So anyways, another thing that especially struck out to us was that Elon himself reiterated in their latest video that yes, indeed, SpaceX would still want to perform this mission in 2023. You have heard that correctly. Still on track for 2023. Now, is this another case of Elon time? Spoiler alert, in our opinion, quite possibly yes. We have to keep in mind that even though Starship SN10 now finally demonstrated the viability of the landing procedure, Starship still has yet to fly to low Earth orbit. For that, the Super Heavy booster will be needed. This monster will have 28 sea-level Raptor engines installed, each one capable of producing 2200 kilonewtons of thrust, so over 60 meganewtons of thrust in total for the whole booster. This will be quite the beast. In fact, it will be so loud that it will have to be launched from the two oil rigs Deimos and Phobos, which SpaceX is currently retrofitting for use as a launch and return platform for Starship Super Heavy launches. But the Super Heavy has not even been tested yet once. It will have to undergo its own testing campaign, if we are lucky, and only one or two will explode, then we might, with a lot of luck, have the first orbital test flight. So this means a flight of Super Heavy together with Starship by early 2022, but actually far more likely by late 2022. Then of course this launch must be successful. If not, there will be more delays.
This also means a perfect re-entry of Starship and a perfect landing of the Super Heavy booster. Then of course, Starship plus Super Heavy will have to be validated on many Starlink launches in order to ensure a very high safety margin. So we'd say that this means that at least 100 launches without a major risky incident. If there's only one explosion, there will be a huge delay, because you obviously cannot launch humans on board right away after such an event. So realistically, best case, we can be extremely happy to see the dearMoon mission lunar round trip take place in 2024. Let there be just one major incident on a Starlink mission, we will see a delay of a further year, until the error is proven to be corrected, and that such an event would not occur again. So this means our realistic estimate for the dearMoon mission is 2025, and our guesstimates until now were quite accurate. Of course, we hope for 2023, but let's not be sad if it's a bit later. What is two more years of waiting? Because come on, we've been waiting since 1972 for a damn return to the moon. It should have already happened decades ago. So we probably won't be too sad if the dearMoon mission only takes place in 2025. Of course, it will also be interesting to see when the Artemis 2 mission takes place, which is NASA's own lunar round-trip mission. We guess in 2023 or 2024 at the latest. So yes, the next years will be extremely exciting, and we are happy to have the dearMoon mission as a validation mission for Starship. It will be one of the most important milestones in human spaceflight, and will open up the era of lunar tourism. And you can even join. How awesome is that?
And as always, we'd like to thank all the people who help us on our Discord server with the channel here. These are Zabol Chiare, Michael Root, Jay King, Stefan van der Feest,
Another Space Nut, Frederick, Miko, Rich LB,
the guy who always changes his name, MLLT, Warhawk, Lucky Green, and Centauri Sparrow.
You guys are great, and your help is much appreciated.
So don't forget the space models, the link is in the description. And thanks for watching the JS Space Report as always. So then I would say, on to the future.